November 121 Lima Alpha, Bartow Ground, runway 9 left, taxi via Bravo Alpha.
Welcome to the Commissioner's Report. I'm Miles Vance. Here in Polk County, we have a great history of aviation and aviation-related ingenuities and advancements going all the way back to the early days of flight. Today, we're here at the Bartow Airport. I'm joined by County Commissioner Bill Braswell and Executive Director John Helms, and we're going to talk about the latest and greatest in aviation technology that's happening right here in Polk County. Welcome to the show.
Glad to be here.
Thanks for having us. Director Helms, would you talk to us about what we see behind us here, this giant array of screens, and what makes this unique?
Yeah, well, welcome to the Bartow Remote Tower Center. This is the first installation here, which is Bartow Airport. As you see behind you, the exact view that the air traffic control tower sees up in the facility. Soon we'll be adding Winter Haven Airport onto this, within this facility, and the same type of technology. And this is the most advanced cutting edge technology in air traffic control tower services in the country.
And what does this offer that you don't get with a normal manned tower or within an airport that doesn't have a tower? What's unique about this?
So digital remote towers offer several types of workload enabling features for the air traffic controllers, such as we have the ability to place bounding boxes over the aircraft to help identify aircraft coming in and out of the airspace. We can overlay ADS-B tracking information to show the aircraft's tail number, its speed, its altitude, assisting the controller with arriving and departing traffic. We have infrared cameras and advanced pan tilt zoom systems to allow us to see air traffic in inclement weather, as well as we have an arrangement of overlays that can be placed directly on the field to identify runway closures, obstructions on runways, the approach paths into the airport, the different taxiways, and various reporting points for the air traffic controllers to help ease their workload.
I mean, in aviation, situational awareness is a big deal. Knowing what's happening all around you, this enhances that just amazingly. I mean, I think it's so far ahead of everything else. It just amazes me. And you got a full 360 shot right there. You can see everything happening on the airport all at once.
Exactly. This benefits not just the people who are working in the tower or working at the airport, but also the pilots and the passengers on the plane. It helps everybody be more secure, and this technological advancement is something that's really exciting.
Well, we've been watching this thing, and it finds airplanes out on the horizon that you can't even hardly see with your eyes. It picks them up, identifies them. John was just showing me, tells you how high they are, who they are, where they're going. I mean, it's crazy. I mean, it's amazing.
Additional to that, you in a traditional air traffic control tower, to see, for example, Bartow, the main runways traffic pattern is north of the tower while the runways are south of the tower. So the controller actually has to turn around, walk to the other side of the cab, and look out the window to identify traffic. This is a 130-degree viewpoint with a 360-degree view within the array itself. So the primary surface of the airport is always within the controller's view, and to look behind them instead of having to turn around and walk to the other side, taking their eyes off of their primary surface, they can just look to their right or left and have that view behind them. So the entire 360-degree view of the airport stays in their periphery at all times.
I think one of the most interesting things about this technology is that you're going to be able to not only run the Bartow Airport, which we are physically located at, but also the Winter Haven Airport, which is some miles away. Can you talk about how that technology works, how you're able to control the airport over there from this location?
Right. So that's the remote side of the digital remote tower. We can put the camera array system on a mast at Winter Haven Airport, and using a direct dark fiber connection between the two airports, we can set up another controller workstation just like this one for Winter Haven right next to us in this building. And through that direct connect optical line, we can control in real time with no delays. From here, we'll be able to control Winter Haven's traffic right here on facility at Bartow. So it will be truly a remote operation.
Theoretically, you could control something or an airport anywhere, right?
Yeah, ultimately that would be, if you can overcome the communications distances and making arrangements for that, whether it be through a fiber connection or satellite interface, you could theoretically control traffic anywhere in the world.
And Winter Haven does not have a tower at all right now, and they've got a lot of training going on over there.
Yes, Winter Haven has a high concentration of pilot training, and they need the services. They have high densities during their peak hours during the day, and we're hoping to help increase the safety at that airport with this by bringing on air traffic services.
Now, John, another thing that's going on in the aviation world right now is there's a national shortage of air traffic controllers. It's a tough job, a demanding job, and you have to be qualified to do it. Talk to me about the partnership that you have with Travis Technical College and what's going on in terms of training ATCs here at the airport.
In 2018, we started looking into the opportunity to train controllers. Travis Technical Institute, Bartow Airport, and ATCFO partnered to bring the first air traffic control tower operator trade school into the system. So now we are, since March, training control tower operators specifically and providing them with their first CTO and helping them find employment within the federal contract tower program.
Is this the only privately run, I don't know if it's really private, but outside of the FAA doing this sort of stuff, is this the only other outside operation?
So there is a CTI program, which is a collegiate initiative. There are a few schools that offer training in towers as part of the CTI program, and there are a couple of colleges that do offer a control tower operator certificate as part of their programs. We're the only fully public trade school vocational institution program in the country.
And that's really amazing. Commissioner, can you talk about what that level of access means for our residents or people who live in Florida and might be interested in this career?
Yeah, the opportunities are crazy. I mean, you know, you think of going to trade school and welding or mechanics or whatever, but you're coming out of here with an air traffic controller designation or certificate or whatever you get. These are hugely high-paying jobs, right? I mean, they probably started 6 figures and go up. There's a huge demand for them. And for all this to be happening in Bartow, I mean, it's just amazing.
And I looked on the website, 10 months to complete this program. And $25,000 for the in-state cost total, all in.
That's right.
And you'll make that back in the first year.
Absolutely. The nationwide average for an air traffic controller is over $120,000 a year.
I mean, it's just an amazing opportunity for Polk County.
Absolutely. And not just an opportunity for Polk County, but really something that I think we're going to see soon emulated across the country with the amount of demand that there is.
Yeah, there's a huge shortage. We all hear about it every day. And John and Travis, they're working to make that or do away with that shortage, fill those jobs.
Absolutely.
So what sort of things would a typical student here at the air traffic controller school be learning about and be drilling in their daily studies?
So they'll concentrate on, of course, airfield operations, verbology, mm-hmm. how to talk to the airplane so they can understand weather. All of our graduates are also licensed weather observers, so they'll learn the basics to visually identifying and determining weather conditions on an airport to report to aircraft that are coming in and out of the area, as well as how to manage the aircraft, which quite a bit goes into that, sequencing aircraft all operate at different speeds. There's different altitudes for each of those, and they need to know those in order to safely sequence them in and out of an airport. And then building up that comfort level and understanding of airfield environment, traffic patterns, and how aircraft flow works, as well as clearances for aircraft arriving and departing on instrument flight plans and everything associated with those. So it's quite a bit.
So in these students, they're not just learning how to operate, you know, small executive or municipal airports. They could take these skills to JFK or Hartsfield-Jackson or O'Hare, anywhere in the country, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Once they become a control tower operator here, they move on to their next airport, qualify there, and then at that point, they're controllers, so they could pursue careers after 1 year with their CTO. They're eligible for direct hire into the FAA as well, so they could go to an FAA tower.
Well, Commissioner Braswell, I'll leave the last word to you. Just one more time, highlight what this level of access, what this level of technology, this exciting advancement, what does this mean for Polk County and your vision?
We talk about bringing high-tech, high-wage jobs to Polk County. This is it right here.
Sure.
This is as good as it gets. Again, the opportunities are just endless, and I'm excited to see them come.
All right, wonderful. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. Really appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time.